Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. I'm here again with my friend Jamie, who is a butcher, author, educator. And today, Jamie's going to break down a chicken.
I am, yes. It
intimidates a lot of people. It intimidates me, and I do it all the time.
Yeah, understandably so. Like, I guess there's quite a few things going on. But once you have the skills, and I don't want to like overcomplicate it because it doesn't need to be, but once you have the skills to know where the joints are, It does come apart quite easily, and it is probably one of the most economical things that you can bring into the home kitchen.
Because a whole chicken is so much less than the parts.
That's right.
Okay, so where do we start?
So I like to take the wings off first. I'll put the chicken breast side down. And then what I'm doing is I'm just pulling the wing. So I'm looking for like the armpit.
Yep.
Okay, and once I identify where the wing meets up with the breast, I just cut just deep enough until I can expose that joint.
Okay.
So there's a ball joint there on the wing.
Yep.
So then what I'm going to do is I don't want to cut into the breast. I actually want to follow the shape of the ball tip on the wing. And I'm just going to change my direction and come away from the body like so. So I'm left with a wing that doesn't have half the breast on it.
Yeah.
Okay. So there's one wing. Second wing is going to be the same thing. I'm just going in a slightly different direction because I need to obviously pull the chicken around.
Yep.
So I'm looking again for that between the wing and the breast, the armpit. And again, cut down until it pops. So I've exposed the ball tip.
And it very audibly pops.
It does, yeah. So then we're just looking at the differentiation between the ball tip and the joint, the socket that it fit into on the breast.
Yep.
So we're just gonna follow that around, and now we've got our two wings off.
Excellent.
Okay. Second thing, we're gonna...
So just a off-topic point of interest. When you grill your wings, do you leave the tip on or do you take the tip off?
I take the tip off.
Do you?
I do. And I just find it's... For me personally, it has more of a use in a stock than it does on the grill.
I agree with you, it has more of a use in the stock, but I absolutely love the crispy little bit.
Well, if it's a flavor thing for you, then go for it.
It's a flavor thing for me, but you know, to each your own. Everybody's got their own. So you can either take that tip off and put it with the bones in your soup stock, and it is excellent for making soup stock.
Agreed. Yeah, and I mean, it's just as simple as if I may.
Yep.
You just have to go right in between
the joint. Right like that, yeah.
And that's it. Right, and then that wingtip comes right off.
Okay.
So those are gone.
When you're buying a whole animal, use it all.
Yeah.
You should be using it all.
We paid for it.
You should be making soup with it. Yeah.
Nothing. If you're throwing something in the garbage, you're throwing your money in the garbage.
Yeah.
Okay. So
next up,
put the chicken back over on its back. To take off the legs, I'm looking for, and you'll see them in these chickens in particular, and most chickens. I shouldn't just kind of point fingers, but there is a fat line in between.
Very visible.
Right.
Yeah.
So you just cut on that fat line. And you're just cutting the skin at this point, right? So now we've got our two legs.
So you just opened the skin. You didn't cut any meat. Just open the skin.
Just open up the skin.
Okay.
So from here now what I like to do is I'll reach under and I support my hands on the thighs. And this is just so that I can pop the joints out.
Okay.
Okay? So now the joints have been popped out of the chicken.
Yep.
Okay? So from here... This is where it gets a little bit more finesse, I guess. So I'm gonna cut away the rest of the skin here. So now I have a clear line of sight at my thigh.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to take my knife and just kind of come underneath the back here.
So I can, that's the ball joint at the top of
the leg, or
the thigh.
That's right, and we just snapped that out of its socket.
Yep.
So I'm just gonna just follow my knife just a little bit around that backbone there.
Okay.
That's it, okay? Now I'm gonna flip it over and we honestly have like a blueprint for how this leg is going to come off, this thigh, right? This dark meat to the white meat of the back.
Yep.
So it's in this area here. So the reason why I cut along that backbone is so that I can pull that leg back even further. And now I can just follow that line. So I'm kind of like not making blind cuts. I'm just going to cut along until I can get this oyster out, which is this thick part of the thigh.
Mm-hmm.
And I can just round around it like so. So now I've got one leg off.
Leg and thigh together. Okay.
Now I can flip it around. I've already popped that socket out, and I've got a clear line of where that oyster is, and I want to make sure that comes with the thigh. So I'm going to just follow my knife around that thigh, and I'm going to take it on either side of the back. Now I've got two legs off. Okay?
I love that little oyster piece.
Yeah, it's really nice. And again, like if it stays on the bone, that's fine too, as long as you're going to be using it as stock, but it can stay on the leg.
Yep.
So this goes part and parcel to merchandising as a butcher in a retail situation or wholesale, is that you would far rather have that on the thigh
than on the
dollars.
Yeah.
Okay,
yep.
So the next thing I'm going to do is I need to take off the breast off the bone.
Okay.
We could always leave it as a bone and breast and just cut it in half, but what would the fun be in there? Let's walk everyone through it. So what we're going to do is we're just looking for another fat line here.
Which is really visible there, isn't it?
That's right.
Yep.
So I'm going to just cut along that fat line, right? So keep in mind, like, this rib cage kind of works in a bit of a, like, almost like an oval, mm-hmm. right? So we need to make sure that we're following right along that bone. So what I'm doing is I'm just making sure that the tip of my knife is just following around that rib cage and down, lower. So you can change directions of the breast, whatever way you need to change it in order to make sure that you're getting the best line of sight at it.
I think that's important. Manipulate the carcass.
Yeah.
So that you can, it's easier for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Some of the worst things I've seen is when people try to perform a Cirque du Soleil type of acrobatics in order to reach around something that's going to create more opportunity for an accident to happen, right? So it's small enough and light enough that you need to change it around so that you can make it work for you. So now I've peeled off the meat from the bone. Mm-hmm. We can see how that rib cage goes, right? I'm going to flip it over to the other side. So I'm not taking that breast off just yet. I'm going to flip it over to this side, and I'm going to be going for that same fat line on the other side.
Yep.
So I'll just take my knife like so, and now I can just follow that rib cage again, using, again, the tip of my knife to follow along the shapes of those bones. This is where the wing came off. So I need to just kind of navigate around that socket a little bit. And now I'm just following the meat. There's the wishbone. The meat on. Cut away the skin. Now, this is where you can take out the day's frustrations if you really want to, because from this point here, if you've cleared off enough meat, you should be able to just pull
that out. Yeah.
Right? And now we've got some bones for our stock. We've got a boneless, skin-on chicken breast that I would argue you might want to remove the centerpiece. So we'll go ahead and do that, right where that bone rests. So we'll take
There's
that
There's a little
off.
Piece of cartilage in there, isn't there?
That's right. There is a little piece of cartilage in there, and it might be there. We can see it right there.
Yeah. So okay. You just want to pull that out.
We'll pull that out. And now we've got two nice bone-in, skin-on chicken breasts.
That's a good-looking chicken.
Yeah, for sure.
And that didn't, you know, even with us talking and me mm-hmm. slowing you down, that doesn't take very long.
No, not at all. And look at all, like, I mean, everything, again, is useful. We can certainly get a use out of everything.
Now, what about breaking the thigh from the leg?
Okay, good. So from breaking the thigh, so we've also got, when we look at the inside of it instead of the outer with the skin, we're going to flip it on so that we're looking at the inside. The skin is down.
Okay.
So we've got another fat line in here that we can see.
Yep.
So I'll coin this and shout it from the rooftops, but I always say the drum side of the fat line. So the drum side of the line.
Okay.
Okay? So we go from the drum side of the line. We're going to hit that joint every single time. Would you like to do this one?
Well, yeah. That didn't... Why am I fighting with that?
I don't know. You have to find the fat line and go drum side of the fat line.
So there's the fat line.
That's right.
And so just on the drum side of the fat line?
Just a little bit over, I would wager.
Right there?
Should be pretty good.
Okay, I've struggled my entire life with that cut. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I have learned something today, and I'm very happy. I am very happy. So, buy whole chickens. Buy the best quality whole chicken that you possibly can. Mm-hmm. I think that's important, too.
Yep.
The best that you can afford, and use the entire bird. Thanks for stopping by.
Pleasure.
Thanks, everybody. See you again soon.
Leg off.
That's great.